Hey guys, welcome back to Pokemon Heart Gold. In this part, we'll be taking on possibly more members of the Elite Four than just one. I'm honestly not sure. But let's talk to this guy. Once you enter this door, you will be facing one of the Elite Four. They're really tough. You cannot exit once you enter. Are you ready? Be courageous and go for it. Alright, so let's do this. First off, we have Will, the Psychic Elite Four member. Welcome to the Pokemon League. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Will. I have trained all around the world, making my Psychic-type Pokemon powerful. And at last, I've been accepted into the Elite Four. I can only keep getting better. Losing is not an option. Alright, so with this, I just want to explain something really fast again, even though I already explained it in the last video a little bit. I know that my Pokemon are severely overleveled. All of the Elite Four have Pokemon in their low to mid 40s, except for Lance. He has his Pokemon in the mid to high 40s, and all of my Pokemon are mid 50s. So, whereas I'm not going to be able to like one-hit KO every single one of his Pokemon, it'll be really easy for me to do so long as I have a type advantage against them. And Gengisnap's confused. Please pull through. Thank God, okay. But yes, I know they're all over-leveled. I'm sorry, I didn't remember how low the Elite Four's Pokemon levels are the first time you fight them, but there's really nothing I can do about it, so hopefully you guys won't be too unhappy with it. Slowbro, I'm gonna switch to Devo because I can. And I totally spaced out. I should have showed you all of my Pokemon and their moves beforehand, but I just completely rushed into the battle. Basically, in the last part, I know that I had told you that, well, I didn't tell you, but I had gotten the TM Earthquake, so I taught that to Beyblade, and also someone had suggested in the comments to go and have Beyblade relearn the move Triple Kick, which I completely spaced out because I forgot that the Hitmontop can relearn some really good fighting moves after it's evolved. So I went back, I found a hard scale, and I went back to Blackthorn City and had Beyblade relearn Triple Kick. So Beyblade knows Earthquake and Triple Kick. And also, the only other thing really that I did was I took Queenler and I gave Queenler a rare candy so she would learn Crab Hammer, which is, as far as I know, the best water move that a Kingler can learn because it's physical and it has really high attack power and it has a very high critical hit ratio. Executor, that sucks. Keep in Gengisnapping. But yes, so basically those are really the only things that have changed with my Pokemon. And all of them are level 55 or 56. Or Gengisnap is level 57. Because I think Gengisnap grew level. But, yep. So, apologize again for the extremely high level Pokemon. Because I know at the level they are now, they can take on the Elite Four the second time around. Like, I'm not going to have to do any more level grinding at all throughout the rest of this. We Psychics don't give up even when we're down to the last Pokemon. That's what makes us so formidable. I stumble over my words. Let's do another Flamethrower. I don't know if this is going to take it down in one shot. I know Faint Attack didn't, but Faint Attack wasn't a stab move, plus Flamethrower is stronger. Yeah, Flamethrower took it down. Okay. So, there we go. We have defeated Will. Alright, I can't believe it. Okay. And Gengisnap has the Amulet Coin. I never gave Gengisnap Charcoal. Even though I was defeated, I won't change my course. I will continue battling until I stand above all trainers. Now move on and experience the true ferocity of the Elite Four. Alright, so judging how things are going now, I'm going to do two members of the Elite Four at a time. And then the champion, Lance, will have his own video. Because I know I'm going to have problems with him, because he has Dragon types, and I don't have any Ice moves or Dragon moves. So, let's look at my Pokemon really fast. I can't remember who he sends out first, but I'm going to switch to Hooters. Hold on, I didn't mean to switch. Summary, thanks. I want to check his moves really fast. I know it's extra sensory. which does 80 damage, and it might make the foe flinch. So, Koga has poison types, mostly. Some use Hooters for this. Wahahaha! I'm Koga of Elite Four. I live in shadows, a ninja. My intricate style will confound and destroy you. Confusion, sleep, poison. Prepare to be the victim of my sinister techniques. Laugh again. Pokemon are not merely about brute force. You shall see soon enough. I almost freaking stuttered over those words too. Koga. Alright. Koga's not too difficult. The thing to watch out with him though, oh god, he has Mariados. The thing to watch out with him though is his toxic attack. That really sucks. Let's see how much extra sensory does on this Ariados. Mine's personally better. So hopefully this'll go down. No, okay. Wow, really? Oh, flinched. Alright. Use another extra sentry while Koga uses a full restore. That's the bad thing with these Elite Four members. If you never played this game, which it would be crazy if you never played any Pokemon game, but I'm sure it's happened somewhere. But with the Elite Four, they kind of suck. If you don't kill them in one hit, or if you get them down to the red like I'm doing, they'll just sit there and use full restores. Lance especially, because he does not want to lose. So you have to either take him out in two hits and like have the first hit only take it down a little less than half, so they're still in the yellow, so they still feel safe. But if you get him down in the red, they're just going to full restore. And a Fortress, that's a bug steel type, I'm pretty sure, so Ginger Snap is going out. I know because it's part steel, I could use Queenler on it, because the water will be super effective. But I'm just gonna go for the times 4 and the stab bonus, so there's no way this Fortress is living this flamethrower. I would be completely amazed. Even if the Fortress was like freaking way higher level than me, I'd be amazed if it could survive that. Pretty sure Fortress has good defense and not that great special defense. I could be wrong, but now he's using Muk. They are also weak against ground moves, the poison Pokemon are. So maybe, I don't know. Let's try Beyblade. Let's try getting off an Earthquake and see how that goes. I don't think it's gonna one-hit him, because Beyblade's attack isn't especially superb. I think his attack is 130 something. So it's still gonna be a lot, but you don't get the same type attack bonus. So hopefully it at least does half. That's what I'm hoping for. It would be great if it just, wow. That was so close to one hitting it. Oh no, minimize. That's a bad thing with Muk. This is what he constantly spams, and he has Toxic Sludge, I think. Black Sludge, my bad. It's gonna... Wow, he didn't heal. That was really surprising. I guess he felt safe with his Minimize, but that was a poor move on his part because now his Muk is down. And it's crazy. They've had chances to attack, but they don't. Crobats, I'm gonna switch. Crobat is extremely fast. I'm gonna go to Hooters. And I'm just gonna use Extrasensory. I don't think Crobat has that great of defense. Crobat is just extremely speedy and his attack is great. So hopefully I can take, oh god, double team, no. I can take this Crobat out fairly fast because as you can see, this is a big problem. Good, that one went off. Let's see how much this does. Hopefully quite a bit, we will see. More than half. Okay, I can live with that. Oh, he has a berry. Really? Really? I think if I get this... Okay, wing attack. I think if I get this off, it'll still defeat it. It did quite a bit. Okay, good. At least I got one hit on me. Alright. Be done. Thank god. Okay. Is that his last Pokemon, or does he have one more? I can't remember. He has a Venomoth, so I'm gonna switch back into Ginger Snap to finish things off. And the Elite Four is falling down like flies because all of my Pokemon are super OP. And the thing with that is, like, I didn't want to struggle. One Pokemon left. Ha! I've been counting on this one from the very beginning. I'm sure you have. But the thing about the Pokemon League and stuff like that is I just didn't want to have all of the battles be super drawn out, and I just didn't want to struggle a ton with all the battles. So that's why I train them for hours off screen. But I can see I kind of killed that. Like, it was overkill. You've proven your worth, or whatever the hell he said. Didn't read that, but okay, Koga's done. I subjected you to everything I could muster, but my efforts failed. I must hone my skills. Go on to the next room and put your abilities to the test. Alright, in the next part, we will take on Karen and Bruno, I believe, are the two. I think Bruno's first, then it's Karen, and then in the part after that, we'll be taking on Lance the Dragon Master. So I hope you guys enjoy this, and I'll see you in the next part. Bye!